Hi friends, welcome to next session. So this is the 10th chapter in quantitative aptitude. So this is the 10.1 lecture, profit and loss. So let us see what does it mean by profit and what does it mean by loss, and why these two will come and when these two will come, and what is its percentages, and we will go some deeper inspects on these things in a common business. Okay, let us go ahead. So the first point is we should know some important terminology. So the terminology is, first point is cost price. What does it mean by cost price? Cost price means, it's very simple. So cost price means this is the price at which we have purchased the amount. We have purchased the good. So actually what exactly happens in these type of things? This is generally a business. So business means we need to buy something, we need to sell something. We need to sell the same goods with more or less value. For example, at the price at which we are buying the product is called cost price. The price at which we are selling the product is called selling price. So in these two, the difference between these two will give us profit or loss. Okay, so let us discuss one by one. So this is the cost price. So the second one would be selling price. So selling price means this is the price at which we have sold the product. For example, this is a product. I have a product. For example, maybe I have pens. Okay, I have pens, packet of pens, and I have bought these pens for 100 rupees. For example, I have sold these pens for 120 rupees. So now the 100 rupees is called cost price and 120 rupees is called selling price. Now let's move on to the profit or loss. So what does it mean by a profit or gain, and what does it mean by loss? So this part is also very simple. Profit or gain. So obviously, see, this is called cost price, CP, and this is called selling price, SP. If, for example, selling price is more than cost price, then the difference between these two, so profit can be equal to selling price minus cost price. And on the other way around, the loss is defined as, if cost price is more than the selling price, then I will get loss, and this loss would be cost price minus selling price. Very simple. So these are the basic terminology in profit and loss. Okay, not more than that, only these things. For example, if we have, let me continue with the same example. If I bought it for 100 rupees, so 100 rupees is called my cost price, and I sold the same thing for 120 rupees, for example. So 120 rupees is called the selling price. Now, yeah, selling price is more than the cost price, so I got profit. So how much profit I got? I got 120 minus 100 rupees of profit. So I got 20 rupees of profit in this case. Okay. So we can extend the same thing. Yeah. So we have discussed gain or profit. So this part is over. And we have discussed the loss also. So this part is also over. Now we need to see the percentage. So what is the gain percent or profit percent? So what is the profit percent, we will see that part now. Profit or gain percent is equal to gain divided by cost price into 100. So every time the profit or loss has to be seen by using with respect to cost price only. Okay, so it should be in the denominator. So let us see what will be the percentage gain or percentage profit we have obtained in this particular example. So this will be equal to gain is 20 rupees divided by cost price is 100 rupees into 100. So this will be equal to, we have obtained 20%. So just observe, this is in percentage. Okay, this is in percentage. So I am getting, we have obtained 20% of profit by using this particular example. So similarly, let us see loss percentage also. So what does it mean by loss percentage? So the loss percentage is also equal to loss divided by cost price into 100 percentage. This should be in percentage. Okay, this is the concept. So these are the main concepts in profit and loss. Some other derived things are also there. Let's see those things now. Yeah. So some derived things are here. So first we will see selling price in terms of cost price and gain percentage. What is selling price in terms of gain percentage? So it should be 100 plus gain percentage divided by 100 into cost percentage. So this formula will come with that only, maybe with gain percentage formula only. We can simply rearrange the terms, that's all, not more than that. Similarly, the same thing can happen for loss also. If we obtain the loss, so this will be 100 minus loss percentage. 100 minus loss percentage divided by 100 into CP. Simple. And same thing can happen for other thing also. So no need to write, but still I like to simply express this. CP, what does it mean by cost price? So cost price is equal to 100 into 100 divided by 100 plus gain percentage into selling price. Simply rearranging of the topmost equation. Okay, if it is loss, it should be minus. Simply, that's all. Okay, so with this we can have one conclusion. So the conclusion will be very nice. You just see, if an article is sold at a gain of 35%, for example, what is selling price? So gain of 35%, that means already 100% is the cost price, for example, then gain percentage is X percentage. So how much will be the selling price? It should be sum of these two. So definitely it is 100 plus X. Okay, for example, if the gain percentage has been given, maybe 35%, for example, so how much will be the selling price? So selling price is obviously 135% of cost price. Okay, this thing happens with gain percentage only. Okay, only that equation is sufficient, gain percentage equation is sufficient for everything. Okay, just like gain percentage only, loss percentage will be there. So by rearranging the things, we have so many things, right? Very simple. Now let us have some other implications of this. Yeah. So the first implication is, when a person sells two similar items. For one item for X percentage of gain and second item is for X percentage of loss, for example. So finally he obtained a loss, which has the percentage. So the loss percentage is equal to the gain or loss divided by 10 whole square. So this is the formula. Just remember this formula. Okay, this is one implication of these things, profit and loss. If two similar items have been sold, one for x percentage gain and one for x percentage loss, finally we will obtain loss, and that loss percentage will be expressed as x by 10 whole square. So if a trader wants to sell his product at cost price only, but he has used a wrong weight or he has used a false weight, then what will be the gain he will incur? So let us see, the gain percentage will be for false weight, and he likes to sell selling price equal to cost price. So if selling price equal to cost price, there should not be any gain and there should not be any loss. But he has used a false weight, so how much will be the gain percentage? So the gain percentage will be equal to error divided by true value minus error into 100. So this should be in percentage. That's all. So this is the thing. For example, if he wants to sell the product at cost price only, then but he has used the false weight, then what will be the gain? So he will definitely get gain because he has used the false weight. False weight means definitely he will make it less. For example, for giving, in place of giving one case, he has to make it as 900 grams or 850 grams in that way. That's why he will definitely get gain. So let's move on to the some other implications of it. So this is the next problem. Actually, in the previous case, we have seen that the trader wants same cost price and selling price are same, but now he wants x percentage of profit and he has used the false meter also. So he wants profit of x percentage and he has used the false weight of y percentage. If these two things are there, then how much will be the gain percentage? So now the gain percentage will be equal to sum of them x plus y divided by 100 minus 1 into 100. So this should be in percentage. Okay. Yeah, this is last and final formula. So the trader wants to sell the goods for a loss of x percentage and he has used the false weight of y percentage. But in this case, we don't know whether he will get gain or loss. Okay, but this percentage will be equal to y minus x divided by 100 minus y into 100. So this should be in percentage. Then how can we get whether it is gain or loss? So if it is positive, we will make it as a gain. So this will be gain. If it is a negative, this will be loss. That's all. So these are the simple formulae. So based on these formulae, we can go ahead to solve profit and loss type of problems. So thank you so much for your careful listening, and please like this video, share this video with your friends and family, and kindly subscribe to our YouTube channel, and please press the bell button so that you will get the notifications whenever I upload any video. Thank you so much.